There are two types of axial stresses, engineering stress and actual stress. The engineering stress, the area used is the initial area, but actually the area size is reduced. So in actual stress, the final area is adopted. And then, so corresponding to the true stress, there is true strain or actual strain, which whose value is given by ln L by LO, where LO is original gauge length and L is final length. Within the elastic limit, change in area and length is insignificant. So this is the engineering curve, or I mean this is the there are two curves in it, engineering curve and true curve. Obviously the true curve will be more, it is above the engineering curve. The important things here are the proportionality limit here, you know this. After the proportionality, in this region the Hooke's law is valid. This is also called linear elastic region. Apart from this, there is elastic limit. Okay, it in steel B is close to A, however B is greater than A. It means mild steel is a linear elastic material. This is for mild steel. Okay, this the entire figure is for mild steel. And then it is C dash is upper yield limit, cannot be differentiated from C, where C is the lower yield limit. It is like this here, and then the, like this, and C is the lower yield limit or actual yield limit. Stress corresponding to strain is yield stress. This is yield point. Okay, C is also close to B, therefore yield stress is close to elastic stress. C is close to B, so after proportionality limit there is elastic limit, upper yield limit and lower yield limit, and CD is called yield plateau here. Beyond C, the entire portion is in plastic state, which is here CD. Okay, this region is in plastic state. So this is very very important. If plastic strain here to here, this is called plastic strain, right? If this plastic strain is greater than 5%, it is called ductile. If it is less than 5%, it is brittle. See here, after CD, the curve is increasing again after a point E. The point E is the ultimate load point, and the point F is called fracture point, F for fracture. Okay. The stress corresponding to the fracture point is called rupture stress, which may be greater, equal or smaller than yield stress. Okay, it will depend upon percentage carbon and temperature. In mild steel, plastic strain is much more greater than elastic strain. If percentage carbon is increased, then strength increases, whereas the ductility reduces. So you can observe this. For mild steel, the strength is 250. For torsion steel, the strength is more, and for high tensile steel, the strength is much more, right? You have to remember this. The short column fails in crushing and yielding or yielding, whereas long column fails on buckling. Okay, this is important. The rubber is brittle, you have to remember this. The cast iron is more elastic compared to mild steel, and aluminium is more elastic compared to both of the other two. And see the cork here, this is important. Rubber and cork are brittle, whereas the mild steel, aluminium and cast iron are elastic. Elasticity. See, the curve is loaded from O to E, and then it is taken to B. From there the stress is again reduced and it came to C. So there is a residual or plastic strain in it, and this energy is lost. It is called plastic or non-elastic, and whereas this energy is regained, so it is called elastic or hyperelastic region. The strain is released strain. Elasticity is that property of the metal due to which the initial dimensions are recovered after unloading. So if loading is done beyond the elastic limit, then the unloading curve will be different from the loading curve. but the slope of the unloading curve will be as same as that of the initial portion of the loading curve. So you see this. So if it is within the elastic limit, it is called elastic strain energy per unit volume, which is also called as modulus of resilience. Whereas if it is in the hyperelastic region, it is called modulus of hyper resilience. Always remember this model of hyper resilience is more than that of resilience. So when the specimen is continuously unloaded and reloaded, strain hardening occurs, which increases strength but decreases the ductility. At the end, it faces the fatigue fracture. So rubber is a brittle material due to lack of plasticity. Steel is more elastic than rubber because elasticity is defined as resistance to deformation for the same strain. So in rubber, the hysteresis losses occur. Ductility is the property of a metal due to which it can be drawn into a wire of thin section through tensioning process. And they are tough and they do not undergo fracture easily. For these metals, the post-elastic strain is greater than 5%. Brittleness. For these metals, the post-elastic strain is less than 5%. The fracture occurs immediately after the elastic range. There are two types of modulus, tangent modulus and secant modulus. So for tangent modulus, it is a tangent at any point in the diagram, whereas secant modulus is taken between two points. So malleability, this is the property of the material through which it can be converted into a piece of negligible, very small cross section, okay? Generally, all ductile materials are malleable. It is due to plasticity and hardness. It is a measure of resistance against stretch, indentation or abrasion, okay? So which may occur due to wear and tear or due to constant use. It is measured on Mohs scale. Mohs scale is designated from 1 to 10. Okay, hardest is diamond. So it can be found out by Mohs test, Brunel's hardness test, and Rockwell test. The proof stress. Proof stress is the design stress which is defined for those ductile metals in which yield point is not clearly known. Yield stress offset method is used. So there is. For aluminium, let's take 0.2% as the proof strain. Corresponding to that, a line is parallelly drawn to the initial straight line portion, and then the point at which it meets the curve gives the proof stress. Resilience is the measure of total elastic energy which is released on unloading. It is equal to the area under the load deflection curve within the elastic strain, given by half P into delta. Modulus of resilience. It is elastic strain energy per unit volume. It is elastic strain energy density. It is equal to area under stress strain curve bounded within the elastic zone for linear elastic metals. So it is also given by sigma y square by 2e, which is the strain energy per unit volume. Resilience is desired property for spring action suspension system. High tension steel has more resilience than mild steel. Toughness is the resistance against fracture. It is equal to total area under load deflection curve up to fracture stage. Toughness is desirable property to prevent fracture against impact loading or cyclic loading. As you know, it refers to total strain energy per unit volume up to fracture stage. It is also total strain energy density. It is equal to area under stress strain diagram up to fracture stretch. It can also be written as sigma average, which is sigma u plus sigma y by 2 into strain of fracture. So it is measured by ISOD impact test. Ductile materials are more tough than brittle materials. Greater toughness is required for cyclic loading, impact loading, dynamic loading, or earthquake loading. Due to cyclic loading, fracture failure may occur if total stored energy exceeds the toughness. Endurance limit. Endurance limit is defined as the stress level below which metal has high probability of no failure even at infinite number of load cycles. It is the permanent plastic deformation which is time dependent and occurs at constant load with passage of time. There are three stages in creep failure. The creep deflection rate is inversely proportional to resistance to creep deflection. So the temperature, if it is half of the melting point, creep becomes intolerable in metals. Okay, such a temperature is called homologous temperature. In case of concrete and wood, temperature is not a prominent parameter. So this is linear elastic, non-linear elastic. So this is elastic region and this is plastic region. So elastoplastic. So this is, since strain hardening is like this, this is elastic plastic with elastoplastic with strain hardening. This is perfectly plastic, infinite change in strain with no change in stress. So elasto, perfectly plastic, ideally rigid. Even at infinite stress, there is no change in strain. Even there is no change in stress, there is lot of strain, fluid, ideal fluid. So this is viscoelastic, time dependent. Okay, so this is elastic and this is plastic state. The ductile materials, they fail in shear. Okay, so the ductile materials, they fail in shear, right? There is cup and cone failure and the failure angle is 45 degrees like this. So and then for brittle materials, they have less tensile strength, so the cross section doesn't undergo much change like this. The short columns fail due to compression, whereas long columns fail due to buckling. Long column fail in buckling, short column fail in shear. They are short columns fail in shear. The bursting strength, if a metal is subjected to equal and alike tensile stresses in all directions, then tensile stress at failure is called bursting strength, rupture strength. If a metal specimen is subjected to uniaxial tensile loading, then tensile strength at fracture is called rupture strength or fracture strength. Okay, what is that fracture or rupture? Flexural strength, you know this, failure at bending. High tension steel has more resilience than mild steel, but mild steel has more toughness than high tension steel. In ductile metals, plastic strain is much more greater than elastic strain.